Virginia. My question here is, how to change the series of thoughts, like, you know, what we are tapped into. We know that, you know, these thoughts should not come, but it can just come back again and again. How to just change the series of thoughts?
Thank you. The thoughts are coming out of impressions sitting inside, and the impressions are coming out of residual memories or fears. Memories can be fears. It may not have, probably memories are not your own experience and that memories. It could be fears you collected from this life or another life or from people or from society. So this is the cause for those thoughts. So when you look at those thoughts as if like there are children playing in this garden, you're looking at them. You are neither happy nor sad, and you are just looking at them. And like that, if you can look at your thoughts, it will become weaker. Because when you are involved in thoughts, or when you are affected by thoughts, they stay longer, or they keep coming back, especially when you are affected. Like somebody, like we have experienced, like somebody whom we deeply love behaves in a very bad way with us. We become affected. Sometimes we can't do anything that day because we feel very depressed. There was an expectation connected to it. Right? That expectation is broken. We feel, we suffer. So if there is no expectation, what will be the feeling? Nothing can tilt you. Nothing can destabilize you. Thoughts are just our own children. Our thoughts are our own children. Just consider they have happened because there is an impression connected to it. When it mixed with breath, it became a thought. And these thoughts will keep coming, and let them come. But you have nothing to do with it. You are watching it. You are experiencing a particular thought. Another option, surrender them. They are not mine. I leave it at your feet, to your guru or God or whoever you trust. Keep surrendering. Said, they are not mine. Detach from it. One is objective observation, second is detachment. Both will help to reduce the intensity of thoughts. And how do you know whether it is leading you to a liberated existence? Its frequency reduces. It's not that one day it will not go, because there is a habit connected to it. People are habitually thinking, habitually doing, habitually performing. Habit. So thoughts also are connected to certain habits. We are habituated to think in certain ways. So that will be there for some time. Then that habit itself will become weaker, because you are not receiving any pleasure out of it. You know, when I say pleasure, even a pain is a pleasure in that context, remember. We always keep thoughts which are painful more than the happy thoughts. Happy thoughts are not stored much. Painful thoughts. Why painful thoughts stay longer? Because of resistance. We try to push them away. So it stays. Right? So why do we go to gymnasium? We practice resistance. So you have good muscles. So resistance is also connected to endurance. So you take it in the right mode or the positive mode. This resistance is keeping it. Now you are not resisting. It's coming. It's going. So what? Right? When you have nothing to do with your thoughts, you are not neither entertaining nor rejecting, then it starts to weaken. That's what I told before, that sometimes they are outside of you, they can't influence you, then they die.